अवार्ड विनर इज डॉक्टर सोमेश गुप्ता, एडिशनल प्रोफेसर डर्मेटोलॉजी एंड वेनेरोलॉजी, एम्स न्यू दिल्ली. ही रिसीव द डॉक्टर आर्थर सर्वनमुथु थम्बैया अवार्ड, विच वॉज इंस्टीट्यूटेड फ्रॉम दिस ईयर 2014 टू रिकग्नाइज द बेस्ट पब्लिश्ड और अनपब्लिश्ड ओरिजिनल रिसर्च वर्क बाय अ बायोमेडिकल साइंटिस्ट बिलो द एज ऑफ 45 ईयर्स इन क्लिनिकल एंड और प्रिवेंटिव डर्मेटोलॉजी, मेडिकल माइकोलॉजी, माइकोलॉजी, डर्मेटोपैथोलॉजी और एनी ऑफ द बेसिक साइंसेस सच एज इम्यूनोलॉजी, फोटोबायोलॉजी और जेनेटिक्स अमंगस्ट अदर्स रिलेटेड टू द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ डर्मेटोलॉजी. The award is in the form of a bronze medal and a cash prize. The topic is a randomized trial of intralesional injection of Mycobacterium W vaccine versus imiquimod cream to compare the efficacy, safety and genotype specific viral load decline after patients after treatment in patients with anogenital warts.
Thank you, sir. I'm honored to be here and receive this award given by National Academy of Medical Sciences, and honored to be at AIIMS Rishikesh in this nicely organized conference with the students yesterday performing so well and taking keen interest in scientific proceedings. I must acknowledge contribution of other people in this. Pankaj is PhD scholar, Dr. Lalit Dar is from microbiology additional professor, and they particularly did most of the microbiology work. The study was funded by Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, and I have no conflicts of interest. Now, human papilloma virus is the commonest sexually transmitted infection across the world. But in a large majority of population, it remains subclinical. Nearly 40% of people in many societies at 40 years of age will be HPV positive. It produces single or multiple exophytic warts, and in its natural course, it resolves they resolve on their own in a large majority of the patients, but they remain unchanged or increase in size or number in nearly 20% or 30% of the patients. HPV is an ancient stable DNA virus. It has co-evolved with humans over several thousands of years. So, and it has only human host and no other natural host. And it has evolved several mechanisms to avoid host immune response. It cannot subvert the immune response of the host, but it can avoid immune detection in the host. How it does to understand that, we need to understand the life cycle of human papillomavirus. It infects epidermis, but it cannot invade intact epidermis. Rather, it needs a microtroma to enter to the basal layer, which primarily gets infected by this. And here there are certain surface receptors which help this virus enter into the cell and subsequently into the nucleus. And through microtoma, this enters to the basal layer. And here there are some early sets of genes which are expressed when this virus is in the nucleus, and which is responsible for replication. And there are some late sets of genes which are expressed in the superficial layers. So the life cycle gets completed here with the assembly of new virions. But these late genes are synthesize the capsid, and which are highly immunogenic. And early genes are expressed within the nucleus of the host cells. And eventually these virions, they are released, and the cycle is complete. Now in this whole cycle, we can see that the life cycle of HPV is tied to keratinocyte differentiation program, and it doesn't lead to lysis of the keratinocytes, so no warning signals are sent. That's why immune weekly interval and total of 8 injections were given. And also these patients were put on imiquimod or vehicle cream, depending on which group they are. And this was started from week 0 or day 0. Then we also did HPV typing and viral load. HPV typing was done using HPV genotyping test kit, which detects 38 types of HPVs. And we did viral load with a real-time PCR. We did viral load for two commonest types of HPV strains, and that is HPV 6 and HPV 11. We did intention to treat analysis, so those patients who dropped out or lost to follow-up were also included in the final analysis. Total of 159 patients were screened, 70 patients were excluded for various reasons, and 89 patients were randomized. 44 patients were in imiquimod group and 45 patients were in Mycobacterium W group. HPV DNA was detected in 84 of 89 patients, and gold standard was just clinical diagnosis of genital warts. A high risk of HPV types were found in 25% of the patients, and infection with more than one HPV types were also detected in 22 patients. The baseline characteristics between these two groups were quite similar, and lifetime number of sex partners was 2.1 in imiquimod group and 2.2 in MW group, suggesting that these patients are not having highly promiscuous behavior. The HPV typing, as I mentioned, that HPV 6 and HPV 11 were the commonest, but importantly, 25% of the patients were having high-risk HPV groups, which are responsible for various reproductive tract and genital cancers, including cancer cervix. Coming to the response to treatment, 59% of the patients in imiquimod group and 67% of patients in MW vaccine group had complete clearance. And if you see here the last bar, this says the sustained clearance, means those who had complete clearance, all of them had sustained clearance, means no recurrence in 3 months follow-up after the treatment completion. 3 months is, of course, too short a period, but this study was limited with the period. The percentage resolution, we can see that it is quite comparable, but imiquimod response starts earlier because we start imiquimod at week 0, but the intralesional injection we start at week 2. So probably the response is quite similar, and eventually the overall reduction in the size is around 85%. The number of days taken for complete response, there was no difference between imiquimod and MW group, no significant difference. Some of the clinical results, now here you can see that there is gradual reduction in the size with MW vaccine and complete clearance eventually, with the significantly good cosmetic improvement. Yeah, sure, sir. So there were no difference in adverse events as well. Now, there were some side effects in the form of local immunological reactions due to injections, and HPV viral load came down significantly in both imiquimod and MW group, but HPV 11 viral load came down significantly only in MW group and not in imiquimod group. So why the question which may come in mind, why an unrelated antigen leads to immune response against HPV, this comes from this experiment where E7 transgenic mice, which expresses E7 gene of HPV in its skin, when this skin graft was transplanted on non-E7 transgenic mice, there was no rejection of this graft. But when simultaneously another antigen was injected, which was endotoxin or listeria antigen, there was prompt rejection of this graft. So when there is immune response is heightened to an unrelated antigen, the HPV antigen is also detected and cleared from the lesions. So I will not go into the details. Just last slide, what this study aids. This is the first study of HPV genotype pattern in Indian patients with anogenital wart. The first randomized trial comparing intralesional antigen therapy with standard or any kind of therapy. This study demonstrates that virological clearance or decline in viral load happens after immunotherapy. And virological clearance was more efficient in cases of HPV 6 than HPV 11. And this study demonstrates no relationship of HPV genotype or multiplicity of high-risk HPV type with therapeutic response or virological clearance with immunotherapy. Thank you all for your attention.
Just one question.
The symptoms you see in these patients, is it because of the consequence of virus or because of the secondary infection?
In many patients, these are asymptomatic, but it has significant impact on the quality of life and psychological impact. But these tumors, they may look large, but they are generally asymptomatic.
If the what is this miracle the MW is doing in terms of immunoregulation?
Yeah, because this HPV it persists because it remains undetected or immune response is inadequate. So this bacilli, which are highly immunogenic, when they are injected into the these viral warts, they attract antigen presenting cells which not only process the bacilli but also process HPV and leads to immune response against HPV. Yeah, that's what our hypothesis is, and that's what we feel because of the clinical response we have seen. No, you know, we are going to do PBMC assay in the next phase of
study. I think we could continue with the discussion at tea or something.
Huh? Yeah. Thank you. Sir.
Thank you. Now we must.
We are thankful to the respected chairpersons as well as to the speakers for presenting their scientific work. Now we.